This is a virtual solar system. You can zoom, navigate, you can explore at your own pace, and that's some of the powers of using virtual reality.
Oh, hi, this is Burns Hargis. I'm president of Oklahoma State University, and we're here for another edition of Inside OSU. And today is very special because we're entering the world of virtual reality. We're here at the Virtual Reality Lab at the Advanced Technology and Research Center at Oklahoma State University. This is the only lab of its kind in Oklahoma. And with me are two engineering students. I have Shawn Parsons, who's from Ida Bell, an aerospace engineering sophomore. And to my left is C.J. Williams from Booker T. Washington in Tulsa, a master's student in engineering management, correct?
Yes, sir.
Oh, good. I got it right. C.J., tell me about how this tool helps you in class.
Well, microassembly is a complex subject in itself. So to make things easier, Dr. Cecil used virtual simulations to teach us different work cells and genetic algorithms.
Shawn, tell us how this has changed the experience for students.
With these type of tools, you can really immerse and be interactive with things that you would never be able to because of expenses or accessibility. For example, we have a program where you can explore the International Space Station. So what student's going to be able to ever be able to do that
right
from a classroom except with tools like this? So it's really great.
CJ, I understand that you had a program that was especially helpful in your studies here.
Yes, it was. It was basically a virtual simulation of the work cells that are located behind us. And what Dr. Cecil did was just create a simulation of the different work cells on a micro level to give us an easier understanding of what was going on.
Well, you heard us refer to Dr. Joe Cecil, who is head of this lab here. And with us also is Vahid Rahneshin, who is a doctoral student in engineering. Well, this is quite a setup here, Dr. Cecil.
Thank you.
Explain how you're using this in the classroom.
So one of our very innovative ways is to create these virtual environments. While they take some time, once we build them, we ask students to go in and explore them, either by themselves or in teams. So when you have a complex domain like microassembly, we've created, for instance, an advanced microfactory. Students can look at planning algorithms, which are very difficult to understand when you teach them using chalk or just a blackboard. And these environments, you know, and that's our claim to fame. We are one of the few universities. We've demonstrated that the students perform very well when you create a very advanced virtual reality environment.
Yeah.
The grades simply go up. So that's the
important. It can also save a lot of money, I guess.
Exactly,
as you're going through this. Vahid, you have all been involved in the research that's going on here as well, not just teaching in the classroom, but the research. And I understand that there's some techniques that have a great promise in medicine.
Yes, actually, we are trying to develop a virtual environment for orthopedic surgery. So we try to help surgeons plan their surgery before they really perform it in the operation room. And also,
you can actually go in and into a virtual body and do the surgery, and if you kill that one, you want to do something different when you try it again.
And that's exactly the benefit.
Yeah.
To help them avoid make mistakes and to accrue experience, which is very critical in surgery.
Another real terrible scourge that we have in the world is autism.
Right.
Some estimate that 1 out of 88. Children have autism.
Right.
Tell us about where virtual reality is assisting in the fight against autism.
It's a very interesting project because we are bringing in kids roughly from 5 years to 10 years, and we think there is a great potential in them learning, and just with an autistic child learning to interact with others using a virtual environment. So these kids actually come to the lab, and we have different mockups of different environments. And then the module that we are working on, it's a work in progress, we're going to teach them science and math concepts. So we believe that they can learn more effectively. And some of them have shown an interest to interact with these virtual avatars. because when we talk to these kids, they say some of the human adults don't understand them. But this avatar is very patient because it's inside the computer. And if
but,
they
but
don't
it
like
appears
it,
to be a person.
It appears to be a person with a great amount of patience who can explain to them concepts very simply. And or they can change and go to a different room and a different module and rerun the same learning module.
Well, thank you very much for demonstrating this to us. I think you're going to show me how to drive this.
Yes, yes, if you can ride this.
Yeah, yes. You get this.
And you get the stereo images, and you may have to come a little bit closer.
Yeah.
And then using these crosshairs on the left side,
right.
You can zoom in.
Oh, my
you
word.
Can,
oh, my goodness. This really is like you're there.
Yes, and the benefit comes in cost. If there are mistakes made, teams of engineers can work together.
Yeah, and you don't have to build all this stuff.
That's right.
Except in the computer.
No, except in the computer world.
I see.
Okay.
Well, that is just remarkable. I think you can see that true cutting-edge research that will benefit our state, the nation, and the world is happening right here at Oklahoma State University, right here in this virtual reality lab.
Okay.
So thank you, Dr. Cecil.
Thank you again,
thank
Dr.
you, Vahid. And we appreciate Shawn and CJ participating in this Inside OSU. We'll see you next time.